So, when we talked about potential energy, it is the energy possessed by an object by virtue of its configuration or its height. For example, when your watch stops working, you wind it, right? So, wound spring has potential energy. Similarly, if you have an arrow and a bow or a catapult, then if you do not pull the string of the bow, the arrow will not go far. So, if you have to throw a stone, let us take an example of this paper. Let us make a paper rider. Okay, and see, now if I want to throw this paper rider at a greater distance, I have to stretch it more. So the stretched spring, stretched rubber band, stretched bow, wound spring of a watch or a toy has which energy?
Potential energy.
Right. You get those toys also when you pull the string. There is a string. You pull the string and the toy starts moving. And after some time, the toy stops. Now, why did the toy stop? Because whatever potential energy has been given to the toy, that has been converted into kinetic energy, right? So kinetic energy is the energy possessed by an object due to its motion. Potential energy is the energy possessed by an object due to its position, its height, its configuration. For example, the wound spring has potential energy. When the toy will work, spring will unwind. When the unwinding is there, potential energy is finished. When there is no potential energy, there will be no conversion into kinetic energy and the toy will stop there and then. Now, this is case A, this is case B, right? This box was lifted from position on the ground to height H, moved vertically upwards, straight path. The same box is now first taken here, then here, and then here. The height is same. Now tell me, potential energy of A dash potential energy of B. What sign should come here? It is greater than, less than, or equal to? It is equal to. Potential energy of this object in case A is equal to the potential energy in case B, because of the reason that the box is having same weight and has been lifted through same height. So, the work done in moving the object from the ground level to the height h is given by F into S. In this case, F is nothing but the weight of the object or the gravitational pull on the object, which is equal to M into G. Okay? And the displacement in the direction of applied force is H. So this work done on this object gets converted and stored in this object at this height as its potential energy. Now this object has a capacity to do this much this clear? Sure? Okay. So that's it regarding potential energy.